Morning, guys. It's currently 5:30 on Saturday. You can probably tell I've got my tan on. Got a few things to do this morning before the comp, so I thought I'd get up nice and early just to make sure I have plenty of time. Just got to shower and get the excess off, then I've got to reapply some tanning lotion just to make it a bit better colour, although it looks pretty good at the moment. Then the plan is to, I carbed up yesterday fairly heavily, so I should probably weigh about 84 now, maybe even a bit more. That'll all just be glycogen going back into the muscles. Then I'm actually going to get one or two sausage and egg McMuffins from Macca's. Just need the fats, carbs and sodium so that I can get a good pump backstage. But yeah, I'll show you all that as I go along. I'll try and get as much footage as I can, but yeah, it might be a bit hard when I'm backstage trying to pump up and stuff. So yeah, I'll catch up with you guys in a sec. I just applied some of the dark tanning lotion, so got a little bit more color now. If you can see. So I'm pretty happy with that colour, just sipping on a coffee. I weighed in about 83, so that's a little bit lighter than I expected. Whether that's because I didn't eat enough carbs yesterday or just miscalculated. I might have a few more carbs this morning before going and getting that higher fat meal, just to make sure all my glycogen's restored. Yeah, not much else to do really besides let the tan dry. It's only 6:10 in the morning, so I'll probably just watch some YouTube, get motivated, do what I can. So yeah, I'll catch up with you guys when I head off to Macca's. The tractor will run you down if you don't move. I wanna linger. Can I please get two sausage and egg McMuffins by themselves? Two sausage and egg McMuffins by themselves.
Yeah,
no, that's it, thanks. Thanks.
Industrialized niggas change soon that you get in. Throw them on an auction block, CEOs bidding. Highest price paid for those whack lines made.
Just got back from Macca's, so here we've got two sausage and egg McMuffins. What I'm going to do is, quick shout out to my boy Jackson Pios, finishing his honours in exercise physiology. He's actually the one that gave me the protocol for my carb up yesterday and for my meals today for pre-contest. What I'm going to do is just add some tomato sauce to these. I'm just going to eat one first, see how it sits in my stomach. If it goes straight through me, I'm going to eat the other one. Basically, the reason for this is I need the extra fat, carbs, and sodium so that I can get a really good pump backstage. That'll help with how I look on stage. Obviously, this close, I'm not going to put on any extra body fat, so I'm not stressed about what the calories or the macros are right now. Just want to get those fats, carbs, and sodium in so that I can get a good pump.
You have no idea how good this tastes right now.
Number 82, Emil Nia. Number 96, Reese Sierra.
Number 112, Jamie Wilson. 37, Lockie Clark. Number 183, Ben Richardson. 178, Brandon Van Buren. 171, Dan Whelan. 189, Corey Green. 179, Boda Van Der Meerwe. Number 161, Harris Barclay. Number 49, Brad Haywood. Number 126, Dylan Turner. 165, Mitchell Coles. And last but not least, number 90, Rob Etherington. So guys, let's have you just shuffle down a little bit here to your left, please. Let's get you all centered. How's that look? Good stuff. All right, guys. So, ladies and gentlemen, this is your Mr. Physique Open category. Let's hear it for all the competitors. And I will hand it back to our head judge, Michelle.
Wow, what a lineup. This lineup's just getting better and better. Okay, guys, we'll have a quarter turn to the right. Quarter turn to the right.
Hey guys, hope you enjoyed the footage of the competition. You wouldn't have been able to see the placings, but basically I just missed top five in first timers, and I'm not actually sure about the placings for open, but it was an incredible lineup. Judges kept saying how hard it was to judge, saying it was one of the best lineups they've seen. It was also the first time they actually had to split first timers into short and tall, so that just goes to show how many competitors there were compared to normal. Had an awesome time competing. I was happy with what I brought to the stage, especially considering I did basically all the prep myself. Pretty much every other competitor had a coach helping them with the diet, training, everything like that. Yeah, I just wanted to give a shout out to my mate Jackson Pios. I wouldn't have been able to do it without him. He's probably the closest thing I had to a coach. He mentored me kind of throughout the whole prep. Just if I had any questions or anything, he was always there to help. So yeah, cheers, man. So basically, yeah, that'll be it for this mini series for the competition prep. So yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed it, and stay tuned for what's next. Thanks.